The COVID crisis has shed new light on the challenges faced by the healthcare sector. Both investors and citizens have become more passionate than ever about this industry, its products and processes. My name is Manon Salomé, and my role is to assist portfolio managers in identifying opportunities and risks related to sustainability in the healthcare sector, avoiding companies with questionable commercial and ethical practices and that do not take environmental and social challenges into account. Unlike some sectors for which environmental challenges are central in the analysis, the social and governance pillars have a major role in the analysis of the healthcare sector. The main risk relates to the safety of medical products and equipment. To understand this risk, the frequency of product recalls can be a key indicator. The analysis of the quality and transparency of clinical trials is also a necessary step to try to anticipate a safety problem during the distribution phase. The quality of commercial and marketing practices is also one of the indicators that should be looked at carefully so as to identify and avoid companies engaging in bribery or intentionally playing down the adverse effects of the products. The environmental risks resulting from pharmaceutical and medical activities have long been overlooked. However, the manufacturing steps, use phases, and end-of-life management of these products generate different types of pollution, impacting water quality and biodiversity. The main goal is to ensure a better understanding of the company and the impact of its activities. The risk detail can have negative consequences for stakeholders, but also for the company's economic results, reputation, and stock market performance. For those who are able to monitor these risks, healthcare companies can generate opportunities. Over the past few decades, the sector has undergone a transition based on the development of new technologies to develop highly innovative and even revolutionary treatments. Time will tell how beneficial this transition has been. Here are three examples of innovation. First, the marketing of the artificial heart in Europe, authorized in 2021, should allow better management of terminal heart failure. It is estimated that almost 5,500 heart transplants are carried out each year in the United States and in Europe. We can also talk about the development of immunotherapy, a therapy that helps the human system recognize and destroy tumor cells, and thus limit the side effects associated with treatments such as chemotherapy. Last but not least, the development of robotics for minimally invasive surgery ensures a faster recovery of the patient and reduces the time spent in hospital. Access to health is a fundamental right. Investing for a more sustainable world means directing investments towards companies that provide solutions to the major social challenges of the coming decades. In concrete terms, it is about fighting inequalities by ensuring accessible and affordable care to socially or geographically disadvantaged populations. Alongside, it also means ensuring that companies are directing research and development toward the treatments of rare diseases or neglected diseases.